Hi Cancer, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. And this is your monthly forecast for May 2014. Cancerians, we begin this month with a lot of focus in your fourth house, that is a house that you rule as well, and Mars is going direct in this house. Now Mars has been retrograde since March and it starts getting direct around the May 19th. And the moment Mars wakes up into this house, that is the house that Cancer that you rule as well, it's all about going back to your earliest memories of nurturing. It is how it is. You will be going back to the roots. You will be having a lot of memories around your childhood, around where you grew up. I think a lot of even time being spent with family, with close members of the family. There's also a lot of nurturance that is involved at this point of time. You could be feeling pampered with everybody's attention. And this is a house, Cancerians love being at home. I think this is your pretty much your world. So a lot of, I think besides pampering or being getting that undivided attention from your closest partners, your family members, you're also going to be confronting a lot of issues that may have to do with your childhood. I think either if there's skeletons in the cupboard that are there from your past, from the time that you were growing up, some family history, some family skeletons that are there, they may just come out right now and you may want to address them. So a lot of focus around them. This house is also a house of emotional retreat, like a typical crab. You know, you have all protection from outside and there's a lot of sensitivity inside. So try not to wear too much, too big an armor or too tough an armor this month, Cancerians. Let people, if they want to mend bridges, let them reach out to you. Try not to, even though as a sign you're not somebody who's extremely aggressive or stubborn, but I think just you move more from a defense mechanism. You know, you are always extremely sensitive to hurt or being hurt, or especially if it's coming from your family, that can be quite devastating. So your defense reaction is attack most of the time. But this time I would say if people from your family, extended families, are reaching out to mend bridges, allow the healing to take place. Don't sort of say that, oh, I don't want to be dealing with this, it's too much water under the bridge and this doesn't need to be dealt with. Try not to overreact also in family situations. I think they could be thrown amongst certain situations which may have to do with your parents, with your dad or with your mom, especially because Cancer is also all about mother. So there could be some concerns, some issues, some memories, something which needs to get sorted, or some healing needs to take place, or it's a great time for you, like I said, to be reaching out and mending those broken fences. We have a beautiful new moon that is there in Taurus, and that's going to be lighting up your 11th house. That's a house of group activities. It's a house of common shared ambitions, goals. And when your new moon comes and lights it up, it speaks about new opportunities. Maybe you'll just get an opportunity to get associated with larger groups. It could be an NGO. It could be a cause which is very close to your heart and which helps you attain your goal. So similar thinking mind, similar people getting together at one place and working towards one goal, it's going to make you feel quite supported, encouraged. And like I said, it's a good time to I think explore opportunities as well as to how it is that you can add your bit, Cancer. It's a good time to get associated. So associated with causes that are more larger than your day-to-day life. And so I think it's a good time to be making a contribution or cultivating such projects. Your 10th house is sparkling with Venus and Uranus, and there's love that combines with chaos and Venus, the goddess of love, beauty, and sex, and Uranus is the ultimate bad boy of astrology. So he's going to be causing some amount of chaos, some amount of excitement. It will urge you to take risks with your career. Maybe it will make you push your entrepreneur streak. Maybe there's something that you've been hesitating to do, and you've been thinking, you know, it's too risky, I'd better not take a risk. I think this is a time where a lot of you could take that risk and say, okay, fine, what the hell, let me do this. Ensure that it is a well-calculated risk, because the Uranian energy is very temporary and the transit is temporary. So after the transit gets over, it's shown that with the first sparkle, the fizzle sort of dies off, and you're like, okay, what is it that I was thinking about and why did I do it? So be do your homework well as to if you're planning to move completely different from what it is that you've been doing, what it is that you've been working. It's also a time, I think, where a lot of individuality is going to, because Uranus is it doesn't like to get confined. As a planet, it's extremely eclectic, extremely vibrant, and generally it causes mischief. So I think a lot of you will also rebel against something at workplace that you've not been liking, or you could want your creativity not to get curtailed or hampered, and you would be more vocal about it. You could also be finding, some of you could also be finding your job quite mundane at this point of time. And like I said, you know, Uranian energy has the ability to do that. It will make the simplest or the nicest, the calmest thing seem quite boring. You know, so it likes to come and ruffle things up a bit. So things you could have been quite happy with, you will all of a sudden start feeling a bit restless. Be careful as far as your speech is concerned this month. You could, especially from 19th onwards, you could come across as somebody who is impetuous, immature, and you won't like that perception get formed at your workplace. So be a little careful as to when you are dealing with other people. Also, with Venus being there, and like I said, the Venus and Uranus conjunct is just full of mischief. There could be some, you know, you could get attracted to somebody overnight, and it could just be a very quick an affair, a relationship, you know, which again, like I said, you know, by the time the transit is over, you may just come around to and say that, oh God, what was I thinking? So be a little careful. Try not to give in to all the temptations that are there. They may not stay for a long time, and you may just regret it. You know, it may not just be worth the while. So overall, a lot of time being spent at home, Cancerians, I think, and all of you love that. Like I said, be a little cautious as far as impulsiveness, rashness is concerned, especially at your workplace. Overall, it seems like a good month, new opportunities coming your way. So have a good May. I'll see you again in June. Thank you so much for watching.